What in the world?
Jehovah's Witnesses.
You're not even Christian. You don't believe in the Holy Spirit.
Of course I believe in the Holy Spirit. Look!
What's that?
This is the Holy Spirit. It's the active force of Jehovah. You don't believe in...
the force? No.
Well, I must have the wrong house. It's the active force! Okay.
Wow.
So we brought this for today's show.
The active force. Oh, it didn't work. Okay. Oh, sorry. We're talking about...
Wait, I'll blow the horn. The Holy Spirit.
The Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit.
That's our intro. We decided
we're gonna dip into the bud today.
A lifesaver today is the Holy Spirit, God's impersonal active force
of electricity or power.
We thought it sounded a little bit Star Wars-ish, so we decided to bring Jacob's lightsaber in for this little skit.
Today you're going to learn what Jehovah's Witnesses think about the Holy Spirit.
Actually,
we are on Bible teachings. Only Miss Jenkins knows what I'm going through right now with you and that lightsaber.
Okay. Yeah, I'm sorry.
JW.org Bible teachings. What is the Holy Spirit? The Bible's answer. The Holy Spirit, and this is the Jehovah's Witness answer. The Holy Spirit is God's power in action, his active force. God sends out his spirit by projecting his energy, give me energy, to any place to accomplish his will. In the Bible, the word spirit, okay, so that's their summation. That
so it's just a force, it's likened to electricity. And we're going to kind of talk about some of those verses in the book of Acts and other places that if you just take out the word Holy Spirit and put their definition of electricity in, It should strike you as pretty obvious that there's no way that the Holy Spirit is not a person, but yet he's what the Watchtower says, some active force.
So also underneath the heading, the Holy Spirit is not a person, JW.org says that... by referring to God's Spirit as his hands, fingers, or breath, the Bible shows that the Holy Spirit is not a person. Okay. They do not believe that the Holy Spirit is a person. So you're going to have a battle with that.
Yeah.
So we're going to show some scriptures today to prove that the Holy Spirit has a personality, yep. The Holy Spirit is a person.
Yeah.
And God.
He lives in Christians.
Right.
Yeah, he's a real person. He lives in Christians.
Okay, so everything is either impersonal or personal. So the lightsaber is impersonal. It's just an object. But David is personal. David has a will. He has thoughts. He has emotions.
I'm taking that personal.
Exactly. So, and he's very intelligent. Well, those are the aspects that we found in the Bible towards the Holy Spirit. So we're going to start off with self-awareness. The Holy Spirit speaks and uses words like me and I. In Acts 13:2, the Holy Spirit speaks.
So, like, this is such a great verse. There's so many more, but this one I just love so much.
So I'm going to read this like a Jehovah's Witness, and then I'll read it like a Christian. While they were worshiping the Lord and fasting, the Holy Spirit... Well, I messed up.
That's okay, twice. Okay, so what we're going to do is... we saw a video, it was years ago, and the girl, every time the word Holy Spirit was mentioned in the book of Acts, she took it out and put in their definition, electricity. So we couldn't find the video to put in a little skit for you. So we're going to do that ourselves and have a little fun with it. But just notice, as Laura reads this, and she puts in their definition, that the electricity. Okay, yep. So here we go.
So while they were worshiping the Lord and fasting, the electricity said, set apart for me Barnabas and Saul for the work to which I have called them.
Yes. electricity spoke and said, separate Paul and Barnabas.
Yep.
Or the Holy Spirit, who is a person, spoke that. You see how clear and easy it is to define those?
Yes. And the Holy Spirit uses the word me.
Yeah.
So the Holy Spirit says, set apart me. So the Holy Spirit is aware. It's aware that he exists.
Yeah. To me, it shows, like in these verses, that he's distinct from mm-hmm. Jesus and the Father. He's not separate. He's distinct. He has his own personality. He does things here separate for me, Paul and Barnabas.
Mm-hmm.
So he's in charge of the first century church and the church today.
And if you go down to verse 4, it says, so being sent out by the active force, they went down to Cilicia. And from there they sailed to Cyprus. So the Holy Spirit has a will. It recognizes its own existence. It has a will.
Oh, and just a little side note. That'll also help with that the Spirit has a will. Again, if you haven't had a chance, check it out. Just look up the word monothelite, and you'll see what we're talking about. Mm-hmm. That the Spirit has a will. Jesus has a will. They're distinct from each other. Distinct persons.
Yep. And the Holy Spirit in Acts 16:6 says, and Galatia, having being forbidden by the active force to speak the word in Asia.
So, the electricity stopped.
So, I mean,
I guess it might stop electricity if you were shocked.
So the Holy Spirit even forbade them to speak, forbids them to speak.
Again, it's hard to do if you're an impersonal active force.
Yeah.
These verses are so easy. Like, it just shows that the Holy Spirit's a person. He's not God's active force, impersonal, none of that. And the church, just as a side note, the church never taught that the Holy Spirit was just some active force, that he was not God himself. So church history also shows the same thing.
And Romans 8:27 says, he who searches the hearts knows what is the mind of the electricity, because the electricity intercedes for the saints according to the will of God.
Electricity intercedes for you. That's Romans 8:27. And Romans 8:26, it says that he intercedes for us in our prayers when we don't know how to pray. This is our Christian hope, that the Holy Spirit is your comforter. Jesus even said, it's better that I go. If I don't go, he won't come. Well, one of the functions, if you will, of the Holy Spirit is that he comforts us. When I have a problem at home with children or my wife or anything, if you know someone who is sick, when we don't know how to pray, Romans 8:26, he'll intercede for you with groanings too great for words. Does that sound like electricity or an active force? No, that is someone who's intimate with you and personal.
And it says that he has a mind.
He has a mind.
So who searches, what is the mind of the Spirit? So it shows self-awareness. The Holy Spirit shows will. The Holy Spirit shows intelligence. 1 Corinthians 2.
What you just said earlier, you found 4 attributes?
Yes.
There were, okay, so you aren't. There's 3.
So 1 Corinthians 2, 12 and 13 says that now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the active force who is from God, that we might understand the things freely given by the active force. And we impart this in words, not taught by human wisdom, but taught by the active force, interpreting spiritual truths to those who are spiritual. So I know I'm putting in their words there, but when you read the scriptures with the theology of Jehovah's Witnesses, that's exactly what you have to do.
Yeah.
And if you do that, it clearly doesn't make any sense. Because here, if we're being taught by the Holy Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit himself has to have intelligence.
Right, exactly.
He has to be able to teach. And in order to teach, he is intelligent. He is not an impersonal object, force, or power. So I think that's really important for Jehovah's Witnesses to see. I know I was shocked when I heard Bridget from AZ, she had a video about the Holy Spirit. Mm-hmm. And she was talking to someone, and she started going on how the Holy Spirit could be lied to, could be grieved. The Holy Spirit loves us. And that was amazing to see those scriptures, because it really showed me that the Holy Spirit is a person. It's not just...
What did the guy say to me when she was reading the scriptures? Wasn't she reading something? And then he said...
Oh, he said... you're not going to convince me of the Trinity or something like that. And she said, sir, I never even used the word Trinity. And then she said, it's interesting that you got the Trinity out of that. Because you can find the Trinity in the Bible.
That's right.
But you can't find 1918, the Holy Spirit being taken.
We haven't even gotten to that quote yet. Laura found a gem today. It was something that I had never, ever seen. I'm not sure if we're at that point yet. Laura's going to kind of lead us along, but there's a point in the book, Preservation, I think it's called. And when you see this point, it'll blow your mind. It's something I had never seen before that the Watchtower said about the Holy Spirit.
So Preservation, it's like a maroonish fuchsia book.
Okay. What year was that written?
1932. Page 193, 194. Says, by his spirit, the Holy Spirit, Jehovah God, guides or leads his people up to a certain point of time. And thus he did until the time the Comforter was taken away, which would necessarily occur when the head of his organization came to the temple to gather himself to those who he found faithful. When he, as the great judge, began judgment in 1918.
So, according to, I think, Judge Rutherford in 1932, mm-hmm. he says in 1918, God took the Comforter. He took the Holy Spirit away from the church. Where does it say that in the Bible? The Holy Spirit's never going to be taken away from the church or from the body of believers. He will indwell us forever.
Same book, page 51, says, after the Holy Spirit... as an advocate cease to function in behalf of the consecrated, then the angels are employed in behalf of those who are being made ready for the kingdom. So they just completely knock the Holy Spirit out of there.
The angels and now it's will the be angels. Employed. Okay, well, can I make a point on that? Galatians chapter 1. Could we read just for a second? I'll give you a minute here to find it. Galatians 1:8.
Okay.
And I wanted to show you that when they say that the Holy Spirit has been taken away and they're now employing angels, I've heard something similar to that. What does Paul say about that?
So it says, but even if we or an angel from heaven should preach to you a gospel contrary to the one we preach to you, let him be accursed.
Anathema. The word there is anathema. He's accursed. He says it twice. And this is amazing to me that they would say that God pulled his Holy Spirit and is now employing angels. I would say they had more of a demon visits than they have angels. Because Paul says, if they come and declare to you something beyond what we have taught to you, the gospel, that Jesus is your mediator, that the Holy Spirit is a person, all of this is central doctrine to Christianity. And when you see the Watchtower do this, I was thinking about this earlier, just before we made this video. This is what the Watchtower does. They take out the Holy Spirit and they replace Jesus. So the only thing you're left with as a Jehovah Witness is just the organization.
Yeah.
Jehovah's organization. You don't have the Spirit. You don't even really have Jesus because he's not your mediator.
That's why they have to copy and paste in the comment section.
Well,
because you can't find the truth. You can't find the Jehovah's Witness theology in the Bible.
No.
And so you have to type in, well, why is the Father greater than I? And then you got to go to an article.
Right.
And then you got to copy and paste. Instead of going to Philippians 2 and the incarnation. And
the act of force isn't helping you much.
It's just wild. That
it is.
They don't defend the Bible with the Bible. They defend their Bible with Watchtower publications and explanations.
And they copy and paste and throw that in.
Right. Okay, so let me get to Ephesians 4:30.
And let me just kind of... Okay, go ahead.
And
I just wanted to say that, I do understand copy and pasting. I do get that. Because sometimes it's a lot to write out. And if something is said well here, you could put it here. I understand that. But the problem I have with it is that you're not thinking. You're not going into the Bible or even really taking that challenge to say, what does this mean? How could the Holy Spirit, if he's an impersonal active force, how could he be speaking or separated or being lied to? You're just taking what the Watchtower says at face value without even looking at what just the Bible says.
Yeah.
So my problem with copy and paste is that you're not thinking. Yeah. God wants you to think. He said, I want you to serve me with your whole mind. And if you shut down and just read the Watchtower, you're never going to receive the Holy Spirit because you won't believe who Jesus is.
Okay, so emotion.
I'm going off, sorry.
And Ephesians 4:30, and do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God by whom you were sealed for the day of redemption. Do not grieve the Holy Spirit. So the Holy Spirit can be grieved. That is not an active force. That is not an impersonal being.
You can't grieve that electricity.
There's no way. Acts 5:3, but Peter said, Ananias, why has Satan filled your heart to lie to the Holy Spirit and to keep back for yourself part of the proceeds of the land? While it remained unsold, did not remain your own? And after it was sold, was it not at your disposal? This is verse 4. Why is it that you have contrived this deed in your heart? You have not lied to men, but to God. So you can lie to the Holy Spirit. You can't lie to electricity.
Exactly.
So there's just no way that he's an impersonal or a thing. He's a person.
Yeah, and I think even one of your commenters said that he was lying to men. And I think it's funny that he would say that because the Bible says the complete opposite.
But the Watchtower doesn't bring that out.
Yeah, they want to obfuscate it.
1 Thessalonians 4, and it says that the men were inspired of God, and so he was lying to the men because they had the Holy Spirit or something.
If you look at the subject noun, and if you follow it, it was the Holy Spirit, and then it says you did not lie to men, and back to the subject noun, you lied to God or the Holy Spirit. And to say that he was lying to men, I think in a comment, it just, to me, it's hard to follow when literally it says right in there, you did not lie to men, you lied to God. So, again.
And then Ephesians 3:19, it says, and to know the love of Christ that surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled with all the fullness of God. Amen. So Jehovah's Witnesses are going to say that Holy Spirit is not a person because a person cannot interdwell another person.
Demons can interdwell other people if you're an apostate, but the Holy Spirit can't do that.
The Bible says that we can be filled with the fullness of God.
Amen.
So either it's true or it's not.
Yeah.
And just press and hold on that. Also, Ephesians 1:23, it says, which in his body the fullness of him who fills all in all. And this is talking about Jesus being raised from the dead and having power over everything and how he fills us. So we can be filled with the Holy Spirit. We can be filled
Romans 8,
with God.
Clearly says if you don't have Christ's Spirit, you're none of his. Mm-hmm.
So going back to JW.org.
Yeah.
Under Bible teachings and the Holy Spirit, there's misconceptions and fact. This is what the Watchtower says is a fact.
When the Watchtower says facts, you know they got it right.
The scriptures do at times personify the Holy Spirit, but this does not prove that the Holy Spirit is a person.
Right.
God is not the author of confusion.
Right.
The devil is.
Yeah, exactly.
So it admits that the Bible personalizes the Holy Spirit, but that he's not a person.
And they probably, you know, if anyone just objectively reads John 14, 15, 16, the book of Acts, I mean, anywhere throughout the New Testament, and there's a lot of places in the Old Testament that we see the Holy Spirit too, that there would be no way that you would walk away from that thinking he's just some impersonal active force.
Yeah.
Not taking an objective look at the Bible.
Yeah, it's just ridiculous.
Yeah, they got a ton of those. Did we already talk about that quote from 1918 that they took out? Yeah, we already did that one.
Yes. So, anyway, just don't be fooled by them. because the Bible clearly states that the Holy Spirit has a will, has emotions, has intelligence to teach, speaks of himself, and points all things to Jesus.
Yeah, that's even what Jesus said in John 15, that when the Spirit comes, he won't speak of himself. He won't speak of himself, but he'll pull the things from Jesus and give them to us. So that, again, the function of the Holy Spirit, what he does is leads people to Jesus. So he's not going to talk about himself per se as much as he would to lead people to Christ.
Right. Oh, wow. What does it mean to be born again? JW.org. That's interesting. We'll have to do one on that one.
Yeah.
Anyway, we just wanted to jump in here and give those scriptures that talks about you can lie to the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
You can be loved by the Holy Spirit. You can grieve the Holy Spirit.
Yeah, and maybe we could
be filled with the Holy Spirit.
I want to read one more because I think this one is one of my favorites. When I first read it, and I had never seen it before, 2 Corinthians 13:14. I believe. I need the Act of War, sorry. Acts 13:14.
The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. You can fellowship with the Holy Spirit.
You can fellowship with the Holy Spirit. And that's why I love that verse so much, because it also, and again, you'll often hear Jehovah's Witnesses say, well, I never see the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit all together in one place.
Right.
That's just not true. I could show you over 50 of them right now.
Be baptized in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Yeah. The Comforter, which is the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name. He will guide you into all truth. Those are three persons. One that we just read, 2 Corinthians 13:14, mentions all three, and many other places.
Did we talk about Genesis 1, how they put in active force was roving over the earth instead of the Holy Spirit?
I don't know if we talked about the one in Genesis or not.
If we didn't, in Genesis 1, they put in the text active force. When you look it up in Hebrew, it is actually Elohim. So active force, there's not a Hebrew word in there for that. So you could easily show them Genesis 1:1 through the Interlinear Bible online and show them that it says Elohim, which is God.
Yeah.
So it talks about that God was there.
And there's another place too, right? Like there's a whole other place that the New World Translation has changed the Bible.
Yeah.
We see it with adding Jehovah 237 times in the New Testament and changing Holy Spirit to active force.
Yeah.
So, changing the Bible, changing who the persons are of the Trinity, not knowing who Christ is. And I want to say this on the way out, just before we go, that just remember, the Watchtower wants to take everything from you, the most important things. They take away the Holy Spirit. They say that the Holy Spirit was taken from the church. They take away Jesus, tell you he's not your mediator. And they leave you with what? Them, the organization. All they want you to do is to give all your time, your money, your energy to further grow JW.boring and all their little places that they're building. So, it's frustrating. Sorry.
It is.
I'm kind of going off again.
It is. All right, guys. Well, I hope you enjoyed the video and the scriptures and the clarification. So your Jehovah's Witness friend, do not believe that Holy Spirit is God or a person. So that's very sad. So show them those scriptures in Acts, Romans, Corinthians. We'll have them up above us here. So we appreciate you guys, and we'll see you next time.
We'll see you next time, guys. I'm trying to, if I can. Wait.
After the beep, say something loud.
Thank you for watching. Please subscribe.
Thank you for watching. Please subscribe.
See you.